Good morning and welcome to a
home vlog.
I was doing it like in row, row, row your boat. Where you like start it and then
around.
Around, yeah. Like a circle.
Well, I mean, it's called a round.
Yeah.
Circles are round.
Circles are round. Somebody left a comment when I was talking about how we were going to write a song that was like, just add one to a number.
Oh, yeah.
They're like, that's how kids' songs are. It's like, the circle is round. The ball is round. And it's like, well, what is round? What is a circle?
Right.
It's like throwing these things out there.
I read that too. And it actually made me wonder, like, is a lot of children's learning just memorization?
Yeah.
That's all that it is. It's not like actually explaining the thing. It's just memorize this.
And also, like, it is, some of it's memorization, but others is like object, like understanding. So like if I say this ball is round and they can hold it in their hand.
Oh, okay. Then they know like this is what round is.
Yeah. All that to say kids tunes,
right? Oh, yeah,
like
yeah.
Kids songs. I listened to a song this morning because what we do is I sit down with Jackson and we play over in his play area and I turn on the music.
Right.
And I want everybody out there to try to find the song on like YouTube or somewhere and listen to I Just Love Bananas by Peter Combe and then think about Insidious if you've seen that movie.
What?
Because either that guy is a vampire.
Is Insidious about vampires?
No. Oh, Insidious is about the demon.
Okay.
Either that guy's a demon or he's a vampire and he just got bored with being a demon or a vampire and was like, I'm going to write kids songs.
Really?
I'm going to play it for you and then we'll come back and I'll get Jen's reaction to this.
I'll link it if I can find it in the description down below so that you can also listen to it if you like.
Yeah, listen to this. So like, what do you think?
It sounds very strange.
Yeah.
He goes, I just love bananas, bananas, bananas.
But like with more tremolo in his voice.
Yeah, like, I love bananas.
Like Tiptoes Through the Tulips.
Yeah, that's really weird.
I love it. Right? That's a demon.
Kids' songs are so strange.
They are. So the whole reason that like I said vampire too though is because of what we do in the shadows.
No, he totally sounds like a vampire.
Yeah.
Yeah. 100%.
There it is. What are we doing today?
Okay, so today...
Well, Jackson's asleep right now, by the way. He's taking his first nap.
Yeah, he's having his first nap. And his naps have been... I don't want to say it, because then it'll not be great. But his naps have been really great recently.
His sleep has been okay.
Yeah, it hasn't been the worst, but it definitely hasn't been, like, the best sleeping at night. So we're just kind of, like, middle of the roading it right now.
And next week, he will be 8 months old.
Isn't that just so crazy?
Right?
I still cannot believe that he's gonna be 8 months old.
It's intense.
Really, like, he is just, it's happening so fast. And I know that we always say this, but like, it's just happening so fast.
And as a result of him getting older, we have found out that he requires more food.
Yeah, so we needed to up his food intake by quite a bit. Yeah. So he needs more food. He's doing more.
Right.
So.
And so we are hoping, and that's what the hope was last night, is we gave him like a little snack right before he went to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
And we were hoping that is like the kickstart to getting him to sleep more. It sort of worked. Like he slept a good amount of time while we were still awake.
Mm-hmm.
And then we went to sleep and he woke up like an hour later and we're like, oh, okay.
But so he's asleep right now. I just had my breakfast, I'm having some coffee, and then we are going to, it's nice outside, it's not raining yet.
Not a cloud in the sky.
So I think we're gonna do like a fun little pool day, we're gonna have a little cookout, we got stuff to make cheeseburgers on the grill, we got stuff to make grilled corn, and we're gonna do beans. I'm just excited for like grilling out barbecue type stuff.
Yeah.
And then I also wanted to look into, so this is kind of silly, but if you have a kid, you probably know who Blippi is.
Yeah.
Even if you don't have a kid, you might know who Blippi is. Just, he's got like a ton of subscribers. He's like a kids YouTuber, basically. And so he also does a lot of kids tunes. He does a lot of kids music.
Huh.
And I watched one of his videos yesterday because we are familiar with his music. We're not familiar with his YouTube channel.
Right.
But I looked at his YouTube channel and I watched a video where he made a tie-dye shirt. It made me want to make a tie-dye shirt.
Yeah.
Like, I know that was a big trend on YouTube. A lot of YouTubers were doing like tie-dye outfits and stuff just because everybody was stuck at home and it was just something that you could do.
Right.
But he made this tie-dye shirt and it looks so cool. So I wanted to make tie-dye shirts for like all of us, for me and you and for Jackson.
Yeah.
So I want to look into like, can we order that stuff and have it delivered?
Yeah. I'm sure Amazon has it.
Like fabric dye?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm sure if we typed in tie-dye kit on Amazon, it'd be like, here's 10 million of them.
Oh, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
Okay. It won't come today, so we can't make it today, but I want to make a tie-dye shirt in the future.
I had something to say. I had it in my mind, mm-hmm. and then you mentioned Blippi, and then it was just horses galloping through
the countryside.
I almost said wilderness. I don't know.
I wish that I had one to ride. That's our Blippi jam.
Yeah, that just her singing, had one to ride.
Yeah.
Those notes, I don't know what's about them, but they hit a different level.
It's a good song.
We have like a couple of hot dogs left. I kind of want to do one of those like weird hot dog hamburgers.
Weird hot dog hamburger.
You like put a hot dog in the middle of a hamburger.
Oh, but I don't think, because we don't have
long. Oh, we don't have that much.
No, we don't have long hot dogs.
Yeah.
It'll
just be like a flying saucer looking thing.
Okay. I mean, whatever you want to do.
Ooh. So we're looking at towel bars for our bathroom that we painted. And I like the little things that they have here. Thick and durable. Easy to clean. Safety fillet.
What does that mean?
I don't know.
I'm confused. Hi, little buddy. Did you just wake up from your nap? Say I slept for an hour and a half and it was so wonderful. Now I'm chewing on my banana.
You know what I realized?
What?
We call his naps nappies.
Yeah.
People from the UK call their diapers nappies. So we're like, did you have a good nappy?
Oh,
he's
no.
Like, it's okay, I guess.
Yeah, we're talking about his actual nap. See, we're talking about your actual nap where you slept, huh? Oh, are you sharing your banana with Mama? Thank you. That's so nice. All right, now we're getting crazy. What are we doing?
Looking at new kitchen sinks.
So we got a new kitchen faucet, and now we're going to get a new kitchen sink because our sink is all kind of like scratchy.
Getting a new kitchen sink.
I feel like isn't that kind of like a big deal? Like a big job?
I mean, yeah, but no, it is, but it isn't, you know, it's not difficult to replace the kitchen sink, but most people don't do it.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So, but we're doing it.
We're doing it. So we got the stuff for the bathroom, the guest bathroom. If you guys remember, we did, well, I didn't. Tim painted the bathroom and he changed out the light fixture and then we were going to change out the faucet and all that stuff. And then we ended up getting a faucet that was too big for the spot that we needed to fill. So we found a new faucet, we found new towel bars, new toilet paper holders, and all that stuff. So that bathroom will be done soon, which is exciting. And then we're gonna move on to refreshing the kitchen sink. We got a cool like new faucet, a cool new sink, and then we're gonna move on to refreshing Jackson's bathroom. Yeah, look at that buddy. Are you excited? You're gonna have new paint in your bathroom? One day you're going to use your bathroom and it's going to be so nice.
Heck yeah.
Right, buddy? Look at him. He's like, I don't know what you're talking about, lady. So that's what we're doing right now. And then we're going to take a quick walk so that we can get like nice and warm and toasty and jump in the pool and have a little pool party. I'm excited.
Pool party.
You're not excited?
No, I'm excited. I'm more excited for grilling out.
I know, me too. I'm kind of like, I want to eat that stuff for lunch so that we can eat it sooner.
Is that not what we're doing?
Well, what are we going to have for dinner? Mama.
Milk.
Mama.
Dada.
Mom.
Dada.
Mom.
Dada.
He stopped saying dada.
Dada.
Now he only says mama. Hey, little bud. Are we going on a walk?
We're going on a lion hunt.
Oh, no. I got my binoculars.
I'm not scared.
Oh my gosh. Are we just only... Literally, I haven't listened to real music in so long. I've only listened to kids' music and some Hamilton.
Right.
But that's all... That's it. So is that my life now?
Yes.
Oh no. Jackson, are you excited to go outside with your cool dude sunglasses on? And you got your fan? Okay, we're
bye.
Going. Say bye.
Bye.
Hi, buddy. We didn't show our walk. Did you have fun? Is your little hair blowing in the wind? You love your fan? Yeah, look at that hair.
All right, buddy. You know what time it is. It's time for Dada to make a weird hamburger with a hot dog in the middle of it. Are you ready? You don't get to eat it, I'm sorry. You seem, oh, now you're disappointed. Uh-oh. Then we're gonna go in the pool. I think you're gonna have a nap first, and then we're gonna go in the pool. Does that sound good? Sound reasonable? Sound like a fun idea? Yeah, you spin that thing if you think it's a fun idea. All right. Here's what I feel has happened.
What?
So, we've been having Marley Spoon and Blue Way, all these different meal delivery boxes.
Right.
Where you make gourmet meals.
Okay.
Right?
Well, I mean, no, but...
Yes, gourmet meals.
Okay.
And we haven't been eating out as much. Like, there hasn't been a time where I'm just like... going to like Disney and getting a hamburger or something, a hot dog.
Yeah, yeah.
So today is about me like doing the most ridiculous stuff possible.
Because you can't do it at the theme parks anymore?
Right, so I'm gonna put a hot dog inside of a hamburger.
Yeah.
And then also we're having beans and I'm gonna cut up a hot dog and put it in there.
Okay.
And so far that's the most ridiculous that I've gone. And then you're gonna take and you're gonna make like a...
So we had...
Dada?
So we had this meal the other day and it was so dang delicious. It was grilled pork tenderloin with Mexican style corn and red cabbage slaw. I'm gonna recreate this corn, but we also had another meal and I...
Mama.
Yeah?
Dada.
We also had another meal and I'm gonna recreate that corn. I don't know if you, I just took a screenshot of it, but it was another one with Mexican style corn. The recipes were like slightly different, but I think I'm gonna mix them together and make one, like both of them in one.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, so that's what I'm doing.
All right. And I'm gonna mix hot dogs and hamburgers together for my recipe.
Okay. Okay, so Tim's gonna help me film this part because as you guys know, I'm not very good at filming and doing the cooking. It's hard to do. So I've got a couple tablespoons of mayonnaise.
Mayonnaise, a lot of mayonnaise in there.
I've got a couple tablespoons of sour cream.
So we have like an oven hood right here and the light coming out of it is pretty yellow.
Yeah.
And that made that mayonnaise look super yellow.
It's not that yellow, yeah. It just kind of looks weird. So I'm gonna mix those together. And then I'm gonna add some grated lemon zest.
That's a lime.
I'm gonna add some lime zest and some lime juice and some grated garlic. And then I'm gonna give that a good mix.
You saying dada yet?
No.
Oh. And I'm gonna add cut up hot dogs to the beans. And that's it, that's all that you do. It's a complete.
You're all done.
Yeah. Step one, add hot dogs. Step two, cook.
That's it? Step you got three, the easy job.
Enjoy.
Well, what the heck?
Step four.
Open the box.
No. Step four is beans. Beans are good for your heart the more you eat.
What?
Yeah. How much are you adding?
A quarter of a teaspoon.
Oh, okay.
So this, what is this? This grater is one of the best things that we have in our kitchen.
It's a microplane.
Oh yeah, that's what it is. One of you actually sent this to us in our P.O. box years ago. And this was, thank you, like such an amazing thing to have in the kitchen. What am I just putting lime zest everywhere?
Yep.
Sorry. But this is such an amazing thing to have in the kitchen because it makes zesting fruit really easy. It also makes getting grated garlic so much easier. So, thank you.
Makes grating garlic great?
Yeah, it does.
Ooh, I feel like you're living dangerously. Like, the microplane scares me more than the mandolin does.
Really?
Yeah.
Because, I mean, I have cut my finger on this before, but I know now, like, when to stop.
Right.
So, like, I just wanted to show you guys what it looks like when you use the microplane for your garlic. It's so easy. So this is 2 tablespoons of sour cream, 2 tablespoons of mayonnaise. I would say maybe, like, a half a teaspoon of lemon zest and half a teaspoon of garlic, grated garlic. And then I need to add some lime juice, and then we're on to our next step.
My stuff's done, I just started heating it. The slowest juicing of a lime.
Well, because I was waiting for you to turn the camera on. I'm only going to add about a half a teaspoon of lime juice. That might be a little bit more.
Oh, it's good.
And then I want you to taste it and tell me what you think. Tell me if I need to add anything else.
Okay.
This is like the consistency that you want, though. Kind of like a very thick salad dressing.
Oh, okay. All right, let's see. Oh, you know what that needs?
What?
Hot dogs. But in all seriousness, salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper? Okay.
Yeah. And hot dogs.
Okay.
Horses. So this buddy is too tired now.
This buddy is so tired. I made some strawberry lemonade.
Nice.
Yeah, it's really delicious. But I think this buddy has to take his nap, huh? Yeah. We didn't plan this out very well, because what I wanted to do was come back from our walk, make the food really quick, and then go in the pool. And nothing is ever really quick anymore.
No.
You know, like in my mind, I'm like, this will be so fast.
Never been fast.
I just always think it's going to be fast. So I'm going to feed this little guy, and then we're going to put him to sleep for a little bit. And then we're going to eat while he's asleep, I think. And then when he wakes up, we're going to get in the pool and have some fun pool time.
Yeah.
What do you think? He's like, I just want a strawberry.
He's like, I want either the straw or the strawberry.
Everything. I want it all. So we'll be right back. All right. So I fed Jackson. Tim is putting him to sleep. I am going to show you how I make my hamburgers. Hamburgers are pretty subjective. Like, people have their special ways that they like to make their hamburgers. You don't have to make it this way. This is just how we're making them. And this is how Tim likes them. So, and I like them. I like them like this too. They're really good. But I wanted to show you what we're doing. Tim is going to show you how he's going to make his hamburger with a hot dog in the middle. I don't know where he saw this, but for some reason he wants to do this today. This is his like big thing that he wanted to do. So I'm going to just show you my normal hamburger, and then he'll come downstairs and show you his weird hot dog hamburger hybrid. So what I do is I get some hamburger meat. I think this is like a pound and a quarter. And then I add some salt and pepper, like a generous pinch of salt and pepper, or not even a pinch, like more so a lot of salt, not a lot. You know what I mean? Not more than a pinch, not a whole lot, salt and pepper. And then I add probably a few tablespoons of Worcestershire sauce, and then about a quarter cup of crumbled feta cheese. So, and then we're also gonna put cheese on top. So they're gonna be extra cheesy, super delicious, but I'm gonna form these real quick. And then I also need to oil up my corn. So I shucked my corn, cleaned it off. I'm gonna oil these up, and then we're gonna grill both of these. And then our beans should be about ready. And then we're gonna have a delicious lunch. I wish that we had gotten a chance to get in the pool, but we're gonna get in the pool a little bit later. So maybe we'll eat this outside. So it's more of like an outside day. I don't know, it's really hot outside, so we'll see. But Jackson should sleep for maybe like an hour and a half. Hopefully a little bit more, we'll see. But we'll for sure have a cookout. That was like our big plan for the day. So I'm excited to do that. All right, so here are the formed burgers. And then I oiled up my corn. And then Tim came downstairs and he said,
where's my hot dog burger?
I totally forgot. I made all three burgers because I was just like, so wait, are you just gonna roll it up?
No, I was gonna form it into the patty.
Okay, and like,
right?
I still don't understand what you mean.
Me neither.
Okay.
Let's try it. I'm gonna
do this one because this is the one that was like the least.
Okay.
Turned out the least good.
All right. Let's see what happens here.
Okay.
I have no plan for this.
Well, you said you saw a picture of it somewhere.
Yeah, I feel like there was like a company that like makes these.
Okay.
And they're just like hot dog burgers.
Wait, is it literally just gonna be like a log of burger with a hot dog in the middle?
Yeah, and then you like flatten it out into the shape of a burger, right? Did you tell them everything that was in these burgers?
Yeah.
Okay.
This looks so gross.
Heck yeah. I bet you it's gonna be okay.
Weird. I think it's gonna be really weird. Do you eat it on a bun?
Yeah, we've got something happening here.
All right.
Right?
I'm not sure.
That's a hot dog burger.
This burger can fit so many hot dogs in it.
It can fit at least one in it.
Well, you did the smacking thing, you know, the meme? I know memes.
I know at least one meme. And I believe it's pronounced Mimi.
I thought it was Mimi for the longest time. I also thought it was Meme.
Meme. Okay, yeah, I think this is how it's gonna be.
That's so thick.
Yeah.
Is that too thick?
I mean, not to have a hot dog in the inside. How's it going to be any skinnier with a hot dog inside of it?
I don't know. It looks so gross. Okay, so then we're gonna grill up these burgers and Frankenburger dog, and then the corn, and then the little buddy is sleeping.
So he's been doing this thing recently where he doesn't want to go to sleep. Like, he's so tired, and he's angry that he's awake, but he's like, if I fall asleep, I think I'm going to miss something.
Yeah.
And so.
And I don't want to miss a thing.
True. He's going to go up onto an asteroid and mine it for bombs.
Is that what he does?
Isn't that what happens in Armageddon?
I have no idea.
Was that Armageddon?
I think so. It's been so long since I've seen that. We should watch it one day.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah.
Where'd my ring go?
Oh no, you took your wedding ring off?
Yeah, you're not even wearing yours right now.
Sorry. I never wear mine. mine anymore because of the baby. I don't wear any jewelry anymore.
Well, you take yours off like at night and to like wash your hands and stuff. I never take mine off except for when I'm making meat hot dog things. So where was I? Oh yeah, so he does this thing now where it's time for him to go to bed and he's like, I don't want to go to bed. And I'm like, no, it's time for you to go to bed. And I'm trying not to rock him anymore. I'm still holding him. So, but the thing that puts him to sleep is his pacifier, his Pippi, that puts him to sleep. And so you put it in his mouth and he doesn't want it in his mouth because he's like, I know that that's going to make me fall asleep. You can't fool me. And so he's like, and so you kind of have to like force it into his mouth.
Well, or you have to trick him.
Yeah. So like, how do you trick him?
I wait until he opens his mouth because he does this thing when he does the side to side, he opens his mouth sometimes and he goes, and I'll put it in right then.
Oh.
Yeah.
See, for me, he likes to spit it out even after I've put it in.
Thank you. I can't, this can't, it's like I need a longer arm.
And so I kind of have to like hold it in while he's like fighting me.
Yeah.
And then eventually he's like, oh, okay. And then, but he's still like angry that he's like, well, great, now I'm going to fall asleep. And so he's like, but his like eyes are like,
so tired, yeah.
But he's still like fighting it, and then he finally falls asleep. And what I tried to do today was do that in the crib with him, and it didn't work. He got even more angry.
Oh no.
He was like, why did you do this to me? Now I'm super angry.
How and dare you?
So I picked him up and I held him, and I got the pacifier in his mouth, and he fell right asleep. And then I put him down.
There you go.
That's the trick.
That is.
That's baby sleep, baby.
Baby! There we go.
Going there.
Oh, is that the hot dog one?
That's the hot dog one.
Oh,
no. This one's already started sort of falling apart.
So. Oh no.
You gotta be gentle with it here.
Well, I thought you were gonna use like a spatula. Oh, I forgot to tell you that you need to season your corn. Don't forget to season your corn. Did you burn yourself?
A little bit. Just a little bit.
Did you?
Yeah, just a little bit.
So I chopped up some cilantro, and then this little cutie out here is cooking up the burgers and the corn and the Franken burger dog, and then we're gonna be done here. The beans are still cooking. I got my feta. This is for the corn, so I'll make the corn for you guys in just a second, but we're almost done, and it only took 2.5 hours.
We
so
keep you, doing this thing.
You brought the stuff in, and then we realized we forgot the cheese, so we gotta put it back on the grill and cheese it up.
So hopefully it doesn't overdo them now.
Uh-oh. I believe in you.
You making that corn?
I am. So I used the sauce that we made earlier with the mayonnaise and sour cream and all the lime and garlic and everything. I put it on half of the corn. I think I maybe put a little bit too much, but I don't know. And then I'm gonna just add my crumbled feta. And then we're gonna top that with a little bit of the chopped cilantro. And then also, and I didn't say this earlier, but...
Oh yeah, this is gonna be good.
Oh, I'm so excited for the corn. I think this was the thing I was like the most excited to eat, was the corn, because I kept remembering how good it was from the other day. Okay, and then this is the only thing that I didn't mention earlier. The recipe that they sent us, that I'm like copycatting the recipe from Marley and Spoon, they sent us this tampico de gallo. And I don't know what kind of seasoning this is. I just know that they sent it and then we were to put it on top of the corn. But I think you could also use like a chili powder or something like that, like a chorizo spice.
Like a, you know what it smells like? It smells like salsa. Chili seasoning.
It does smell like chili, but it also smells like what you would put in salsa.
Yeah.
If you were to season, like it almost smells like ground up, dried up salsa.
Yeah.
Right?
That's so. Interesting. You know what it is?
What?
It's the powder in the bottom of Cool Ranch Doritos.
No, it isn't.
I like how you had to think about it for a second.
I'm like,
you're like,
maybe it is. I'm just gonna take a little pinch of that. I just had some extra left over from the recipe, and I'm just gonna sprinkle that on top of the corn. This is gonna be so good.
Let's see if we can see. It's just like spicy salt, I think.
I mean, it definitely is something. It smells like salsa.
Yeah.
I'm sure somebody out there is gonna be like, it's this. Like, and I'm sure it's. People know what it is and we just don't know.
Look at that hot dog burger. Ooh, buddy, it's gonna be good.
I wanna see you like, I wanna cut it in half and see what it looks like in half.
It looks like a hot dog inside of a burger.
Well, okay.
There is our grill out summertime fun burgers. One has a hot dog through it. There's our corn, looks delish. And then beans with hot dogs in them. We call those beanie weenies.
Beanie weenies, remember we used to make those all the time?
Yeah, they were so good. The moment you've all been waiting for. The hot dog, hamburger.
Let's get a good look at it.
Combination.
Okay.
Let's see, I'm going right like direct line with the hot dog, right? Mm-hmm. That's the only way to do it.
I mean, yeah, I think so. Good?
Yeah.
Let me see the inside.
Tastes like a hot dog inside of a hamburger.
That is so weird.
I feel like the hot dog could be cooked more.
Oh, okay.
Like, it's not cold. It's a done hot dog. It's a cooked hot dog, but I like my hot dog burnt, you know? Mm-hmm.
Right.
Hmm. You could kind of go on a flavor adventure. Because, like, if you want just hamburger, eat from this side over here.
Right.
If you want more hot dog, eat from the center. If you want a little bit of both, kind of eat a little bit off center.
Did you invent something here?
Mm-mm.
No, okay.
Mm-mm. Somebody else has already invented this. I take no claim to fame to this.
Okay.
I think there's an entire restaurant based around this.
Oh, really?
They have special buns.
Oh, really?
The bun, like, comes out like a hot dog. And then it's circular, and then it goes back out. Kind of like the shape of Saturn or something like that.
That is so weird. Man, I gotta say, these burgers were delicious. I didn't even get to show you mine. I ate that whole thing so fast. It was so good.
This was good. But I think that I like a hot dog and a hamburger by themselves better.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Why mess with a good thing, you know?
Oh.
I don't know, you got your whole hot dog is sticking out.
No, just like... Because I don't know about you, but I do things differently between hot dogs and hamburgers.
Okay.
Right? Hamburgers have got lettuce, tomato, pickles. We should have gotten an onion. That would have been good.
Like I a thought red about, onion. I know, I thought about it. Dang it, I thought about it.
Mustard, tomato, or ketchup, stuff like that. Like, you put a lot of stuff on your hamburger. Hot dog, just mustard.
Okay.
So, like, you get extra flavors with this that don't necessarily go with the hot dog. Like, you don't really want tomatoes with hot dogs.
Some people do.
I mean.
They do that Chicago-style one, you know, that has, like, all the stuff.
I mean, there's a bunch of different kinds.
Yeah. So, some people do like it.
I mean. Okay.
Would you do this again?
Mm-mm.
No? Are you glad that you did it?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, that's all that matters.
I want to do it with bacon next time.
Just inside the burger?
Cook up bacon.
Yeah.
And then put full strips inside of the burger.
Okay.
Right?
Yeah.
And then, like, form the patty around the three strips of bacon.
I like it.
Fully cooked bacon, though, right?
Yeah, yeah, crispy.
Yeah.
Oh, man, I'm excited.
Let's cook more hamburgers.
Okay. But I wanted to show... Wait, really quick. I wanted to show them how delicious this corn is.
So I don't like corn on the cob, but I do like grilled corn on the cob, I found out just recently.
Yeah.
Like, I've never had it before because I didn't like... I was like, I do not like corn on the cob.
Karate chop.
Doesn't matter where it comes from. If it's grilled, if it's boiled, if it's... I don't know.
What else can you do with corn? Can you fry corn?
I'm sure you can fry it. It's a popcorn.
Can you fry a whole ear of corn?
I think it would do popcorn, wouldn't it?
I don't know.
They have those. Like, you can have popcorn on, like, a cob of popcorn.
Do you fry it, though? Like, you deep fry it? You dip the whole thing in oil?
I don't know how they do it.
Oh.
But maybe. Like, if you have a dried out corn.
Can you batter a corn on the cob and fry it?
Not a dried out one, because it would explode.
No, like, this, all the like batter this one.
Yeah. You can fry anything.
Okay.
Oh, now I have the hiccups.
Oh, no.
So I didn't ever like corn on the cob. I like grilled corn on the cob because we tried it.
Yeah.
Lesson here, kids, try something new.
Yeah.
A lot of people ask me, they say, Tim, is the mustache ever coming back? And I say, no, because it's too hard to eat stuff.
Well, and I feel like the mustache has been gone for so long. I feel like
some people don't even know that I had a mustache.
Yeah.
I used to have a big curly Q mustache. And the whole thing is, like, even now with just a beard, and I eat this, it's like...
Well, this is covered in sauce. This
but
is
imagine
different.
It with the mustache.
Oh, well, I'm just saying.
And you can't, like, wipe that out.
Right.
You know? Like, when you can't do that. You have to do like this.
I remember when you had the mustache.
And then hope that it gets all out and not just, like, goes into the curl.
Right.
So.
But do you love the corn?
Yeah, it's good.
So good, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to leave the recipe for this corn down below. Make it.
We showed it, didn't we?
Well, but I'm going to write it down for them.
Okay.
Make the corn. You're going to love it. It was so good.
Now that we're all done with lunch, perfect weather for a dip in the pool. A pool dip.
You want to hear it?
I miss the rains down in the pool.
Dang.
Sounds nice, though.
It does. It sounds really nice, actually.
I think it's making Jackson's nap longer.
Mm. Hey, how long has he been asleep? I feel like we've been...
What time did he go to sleep? Oh, what's that?
Oh, I didn't tell you. Okay, oh. So the other day, I was looking at the internet And I saw this strawberry hack that says strawberries dried in the oven taste like candy but are healthy and natural. 3 hours at 210 degrees.
3 hours?
Yeah.
Wow.
Should I not do it?
No, do it. But that sounds like, I didn't realize it was 3 hours.
Yeah, it's a long time.
That was a long time.
The oven is preheated to 210 degrees. I'm going to cut up these strawberries.
It's such a specific temperature. Is that the lowest that the oven goes?
I don't know. Maybe.
Huh.
But I'm going to cut these up and put them in the oven for 3 hours, and we're going to have some natural and delicious candy later.
Mmm.
At like 6:30.
Okay.
Get ready.
I'm bad. Okay. Jackson. Jackson, you just woke up from your nap. You want to tell him why your hair's all wet?
Jackson, why is your hair all wet?
Because Jackson and Daddy went out and played in the rain.
You did? Is this raindrop on your arm?
It is.
You went in the rain? What did it feel like? Look how his hair kind of looks a little bit curly.
Oh, yeah. We went outside and we said, raindrops keep falling on my head. And just like the man, his feet are too big for his bed. I don't understand the words. Why is he singing about a guy whose feet are too big?
I don't know. Are those the words?
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, so here is our...
So in my opinion...
What?
I thought you would have to cut him smaller.
Well, but look at this picture. I'm just going by... Literally, this is the only... This is all that I have to go on is this picture. And they're full. They're whole strawberries.
There's whole strawberries. All right, let's do it.
It's a snack hack.
Snack hack.
That's what it says. So I'm just going to put them in the oven just like this.
Yeah, we'll see what happens.
But some of them are smaller than the other ones, so...
Oh yeah, those are going to be extra dry.
Okay. So is this basically, I'm just dehydrating this?
Yes.
Like a food dehydrator? Is it? Yeah. So we're going to let that cook for 3 hours.
We'll see you guys in 3 hours.
And then I'm going to feed this little buddy. Look at that little smiley buddy.
Yeah, look at his like dapper hair now because it's all wet.
You can actually see it.
Wow. Look at how cool you look.
You look like a cool buddy.
He's like a comb over.
Yeah!
You just wanted to show how riled up he is after his nap?
See, I just had some milkies and now I'm full of energy! I'm being all nuts! I like how he's not doing it anymore. Oh, is that it? Say mama.
Say dada.
Mama.
Ababa.
Ababa.
Yeah?
Oh yeah?
Where are you going?
He bit my toe the other day.
Yeah? And then what? Tell me more.
No.
Jackson. Oh, there's a little buddy. Jackson. Are you and Dada gonna play so Mama can clean up the big mess she made?
No.
Yeah.
We're just gonna sit here like this.
No, we're playing with our ball. Say, this is my favorite ball. All right, it's been 3 hours. These do not look like the picture I saw on the internet, but I do think that they are going to be good. Like, all of the little, like, juices are coming out of them. I don't know, they smell really good. They're for sure, like, really hot, so we gotta wait for them to cool off a little bit, but this is them.
All right, so Jackson's now asleep.
Yeah.
We never went in the pool.
No, and I feel like there was, like, this big time break in this video where we were, I don't know what we were doing.
We went on another walk.
Oh yeah, we did. We went outside because we couldn't go in the pool because the rain, it seemed like it was going to rain again. There's this storm that was just like sitting over us and it wasn't moving. And it looked like it was going to rain, but it didn't actually rain.
But we did make the strawberries.
They do taste good. So here, do you want to try a big one or a little one?
A little one, because that way it'll be like more dried out.
They feel like gummies, kind of.
Like squishy.
Yeah, almost like vitamins.
Tastes like a regular strawberry.
But like a little bit sweeter, right?
A little bit sweeter, yeah. Like a little bit more concentrated flavor.
Yeah.
But it's still like juicy.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it was supposed to be dried up.
I thought so too.
I think you needed to slice them.
Well, I literally just looked at the picture and did what the picture said. And this was one of those like snackhacks.com. Like one of those like 5 minute crafts or like a TikTok thing.
Mm-hmm.
And so I just did exactly what it said.
I think they would have been really good if we had like gotten them to dry all the way out.
Try a big one.
I did. I think if we leave them in the oven for like 10 hours,
I mean, I'm not gonna leave the oven going for 10 hours.
But I think that would have done it.
I mean, these are pretty good.
I would eat them again.
Yeah.
It's actually the next day. We fell asleep, as parents do.
Yeah.
After the strawberries, it was just like...
Well, we had a Zoom call with our friends. We chatted with them for a little bit. It was really nice just to like catch up with people.
Yeah.
And just talk about the world and things.
Everything.
Yeah, it was nice. We had a good time. I do wish that we were able to get into the pool and have like some pool fun with the baby. I wish that we... It was just the weather was weird.
Yeah, we just like waited just a little bit too long.
We'll do it. There'll be another pool day.
Yeah, it's right there. We can go into the pool anytime we want to.
That's true.
Right now.
We should.
But yeah, other than that, it was a great day. Like, I really enjoyed doing a cookout.
Yeah.
So with that being said, we are off. We'll see you guys tomorrow. And now it's time to help.
So today's organization that we want to shine a spotlight on is called JJ's Hello Foundation. And we want to say thank you to Josh Anderson for sending the information our way. Josh is actually the person who founded this organization. The Hello Foundation was created by Michelle and Josh Anderson following the loss of their 12-year-old son, JJ, to suicide on February 13th of 2016. The mission of JJ's Hello Foundation is to prevent youth suicide, promote mental health awareness, and create a message of hope for preteens, teens, and young adults in our community. And they basically talked a little bit about how we talk a lot about mental health with older kids. You know, when you're in high school, when you're in college, when you're an adult, but we don't talk a lot about it for younger kids. And it is, reading the stats that they have on their page, suicide is the number 2 cause of death for children ages 10 to 14 years old, which I had no idea.
Yeah, that's intense.
It's just something that because we don't talk about it, I just didn't know that. So please check out the link in the description down below where you can learn even more about what they do for the community. They have meetings, like virtual meetings for survivors. They do different things for donations as far as like pledges you can make. They do Can You Hear Me cards, their tools for suicide prevention. There's just a lot of different things that they do. So if you want to check out the website and learn more about it, we'll leave it down below. And I just hope that you'll talk about it with your friends and your family. Donate if you can. But just learning more about the organization and just amplifying their message, I think would be really great. So thank you so much for checking it out. And thank you so much for hanging out with us today at home. We had a lot of fun. We hope that you guys had a lot of fun with us.
Yeah, thanks for watching this video.
Yeah.